So, in the globe model, there is no exacting science of our vision. Okay? Now, as a human being, I'm speaking to you directly here. You understand that when you go out into the world, the way you see the world is that the floor you're standing on will come up to meet the level of your eye. The sky will come down and sit above that point, just at the level of your eye. And if you had walls or anything on your on the same level, they would appear to converge at the very same point. And everything gets smaller and diminishes, okay, the further it gets from you. This is where this globe has come in and hijacked three-dimensional tangible reality and tried to superimpose this other geometry over the top of it. That's why they will say, look, there's a boat directly out in front of you that appears to be going over a curve. Again, I have to help you understand that the absurdity of a curve on a body of water that is no flowing anywhere and maintaining the bend upon its surface. It is inconsistent from one day to the next because our vision is subject to conditions in the air, temperature, pressure, density, so many variations. There is no exacting science, tangible measurement of how we see the world. But yet, this globe has hijacked it and tried to utilize it and use it to push the narrative that they want to be true, or that they want you to think is true. If it was a geometric sphere, oblate sphere, then from one day to the next, the curving water and ships going over would be the exact same, at the exact same point every time. And it's not. There's people all across the world now who are taking observations, optical phenomena, that are inconsistent from each other, contradictory. But yet, this is the only real thing that this globe has to offer.
Caught up to the ground. I'd rather be a hammer than a nail. Yes, I would. If I only could, I surely would. Oh, I'd rather sail away like a swan. Forest than a street. Yes, I would. If I could, I surely would.
Oh, I'd rather sail away like a swan.
My feet. Yes, I would.